Hello everyone, in today's video lecture we are going to see how to create a pie chart using Struts 2 MVC framework Dojo plugins. Okay, so for this we need a Struts 2 Dojo plugins. Today we are going to create this kind of a pie chart, as you can see, branch wise students count. So that we are going to implement using NetBeans IDE. So let's start with it. So here I have already created a project called Jeffrey chart. So how to create this kind of project? Go to I want to create a new project, file, new project, and you can go to Java web application, and then next you can just write your project name over here, and then it will select automatically whichever server you want to have. Then after this, next, and then you can select out of this whichever MVC framework with which you want to implement this particular project. I have selected here Struts 2. So this way the project has been created. You can see the various components over here. There are web pages, source packages, test packages, then libraries, okay. Then after that, test libraries and configuration files. These are the components over here. So we need to have the libraries like jcommon, jfree chart plugin, jfree chart dot jar, struts to dojo plugin, struts to jfree chart plugin. These are the libraries which we want to have in this. Okay, so let's start with it. We can have we can create a new JSP page like this. So for this I'll just create new JSP. So when we create this new JSP page, you can see here this kind of JSP is created. When we run this particular file, we will be getting hello world, which is to be generated. Okay, so let's start with that. We have already created this index.jsp page, inside which we have given like we need to import tag libraries, URI, struts tags, and prefix is given as S. So if we don't give this prefix, so instead of this S, you need to type this URI, entire URI. Beware that. Okay, after this, we'll just create a design one form, and the action which is given as chart. So what is this action is all about? When we click on this submit button, it has to go to one particular, it has to invoke some action, right? So this is the index.jsp which we have created. It generates the output something like this. So what are the contents into it? So we have designed this S form, the action chart, and then the text field label branch one, name is branch one, and label number of students from branch one, name is stud one. So likewise we want to generate this kind of a chart. So for that we want to generate this kind of a chart. So for that we are importing branch wise students count. So this is our index.jsp page is all about. So I'll just delete this new JSP and new one JSP dot. Yes, I'll just delete. After this deleting of the web pages, we will create new source packages. New source package, inside this we need to create new action support based action class. So what is this action support based action class? Remember we have generated this form. When we click on the submit button, it has to take some action, then action according to that action it has to invoke the Java class. So right, so we are writing that inside our configuration file struts.xml. It is already inbuilt, it has been generated over here. So when we create this struts.xml, it is already there, struts.xml. We just need to add this thing. What are the things which you need to add? Action name is equal to chart, then the class which it has to invoke is free, okay. Result name is going to be success, type is going to be chart, okay. When the result name is going to be success, it has to invoke this particular chart, and chart's width is 500, height is 500, and then close that action part. So we'll come back to this once again. So once we have created this new action support based action class, new action support based action class means after clicking on this particular JSP page, when you click on the submit, it will go to the struts.xml file. Then it will check this action name is chart. For that, this action name, it has to invoke this class free. So it will go to free.java. Once it goes to this free.java, it will see here that what is the action written is success. So once it checks for that, written is success, so it will result name is success, then it will go to create a type chart, and it will create the chart of the width 500, height is 500. You can change this fields as well. Okay, so this is about struts.xml file. So let's go to free.java. This is the main component of our project. So when we create this action support based action class, it has already imported this particular package. Remaining things we need to import. Now what are these things? Import, we need to import several functionalities into our project. So import org.jfree. Then I can import the way I want, like chart dot. Okay, then let's say jfree chart dot. Okay, so likewise I can just keep on importing all the packages whichever is needed for my project. So I have imported here chart factory, jfree chart and default pie data set. Okay, once you have created this, you need to have the private fields. What are those fields are all about? Branch 1, branch 2, branch 3, branch 4. We need the count 1 for student 1, student 2, student 3, student 4. So likewise, we have taken those fields, private string branch 4 and integer number of students we want. We have also taken private int student 4 over here, that is there. Okay, and after that we need to add this jfree chart functionality. Why this jfree chart? We have taken this particular class like jfree chart and we have created the object of it. Okay, we have created the instance of it, right? So chart, we have created this, and after this just click on insert code, getter and setter, and you can insert whichever fields you have taken, you can insert getter and setter methods for it, right? So you can click on it and you will be getting this kind of getter and setter methods to be generated. Once it is generated, after that we need to write public string execute method in this default pie data set. Okay, we will be generating this new default pie data set and we will be setting the values to that particular data set. What do you mean by these setting values? We will be adding the student 1 count, student 2 count to it, and we will try to generate from this chart factory dot create chart, create pie chart. Now remember one thing here, chart factory dot, when I create, I can create pie chart, I can create area chart, bar chart, pie chart, any of the chart over here. Okay, so that functionality is provided with this built-in chart factory class, and we will give the branch wise students count, the data set which we have taken. Okay, data set branch 1, student 1, branch 2, student 2, and all other rest, all the values. What are these values are? So if you look at this chart factory dot create pie chart, so once you have taken, you can see here pie data set boolean legend, boolean tooltips and local. So so once we have created a free.java, you can see here public string execute, all the required things we have added. We have created the data set, we have added the set values to it, and then we are just returning success. Now let's have a look at this struts.xml file. So once on index.jsp, we are going to click on the submit button. It has to generate some action. Then for that action, it has to go to struts.xml file. So for that action, it will go to class free, and then it will go to free.java. It will execute all these things. It will execute this execute method. It will return success. Once it returns success, so it will catch this result name is equal to success. Based on that, it will generate this jfree chart. Okay, so after this, we have seen index.jsp file, we have seen free.java file, we have seen struts.xml, we have seen all the libraries which we need to add. So once you have seen this, we need to sometimes it gives us error that we need to add some of the plugins. So we can just add the plugins over here, add plugins, and whichever plugins are there, you can just add over here. You can just select this plugins and just open this and just run. That's it's simple. Okay, So sometimes it gives errors, so that time the problems needs to be resolved. After this, we will see web.xml file. This is also one mapping file. In this, you just need to change this welcome file list. You have to add over here index.jsp. Once you have added this, so that's it. So we have created this index.jsp, free.java, struts.xml, then web.xml. Okay, after this, four files have been created, libraries have been added to this. You can add the jar folder or libraries over here, whichever libraries it needs. So we'll just run this project. We'll just run this project, simply clean and build. Deploy and then run. Okay, after this I'll just run this. I'll just give index.jsp. I'll just give the branch name as CSE, the number of students 72, branch 2 IT, number of students 86, branch 3 ENTC, number of students 56, mechanical 52. Submit. CSE 72, ENTC 56, mechanical. It will generate this branch wise, students count, this kind of a chart. Thank you.